I there.
What's poppin', Austin? I'm doing pretty good. I'm just gonna be making a little video here. Be a grand old time. Okay, cool. I got the spectrum stuff to work. My lights should be going all over the dang place now. Let me shut off the lights in the rest of the house so that this actually looks, like, cool. Yeah. Turn the brightness of the lights down a bit. Alright, so we are going to make a video. So earlier today, and by earlier, I mean like 2 hours ago, I recorded the voiceover for the video. So this video is going to be titled, I don't know. Let me see. I write a lot of my scripts on my phone because I tend to get the most, I guess you could call it, inspiration. I get the most motivation whenever I'm not at my computer for some reason. So, like, there will be times where I will sit at this desk, at this computer, with this program open, just being like, make a video, GFC, and I can't do it. And then 3 hours later, when it's like 2 in the morning, I'm in bed trying to fall asleep, for some reason, I'll just get this huge burst of motivation to make a video. But I don't feel like getting out of bed. So what I do personally is I use the shit out of the notepad program on my phone. I use it a lot. I've written most of the videos that you guys have ever seen from me. So if you go back in time and you look at pretty much any video that I've ever released, that like an edited video, every single one of them, pretty much the script I wrote on my phone when I was just on the couch or in bed. So, a good example of that is this script, which I can show you right now. Wait, there we go. So yeah, I write the scripts on my phone. And I'll put in little notes and stuff about how I want the video to be structured and things like that. So that when I sit down here, it's all go, it's all work, baby. Like, when I sit down here, it's like, okay, record it, edit it, use the notes I wrote here. So I'll put notes in. So typically the way that I'll write a script, and this is what I recommend. So like, I like doing these streams because it kind of, I get a lot of questions from people who are trying to make their own YouTube channel, or they're trying to make videos and stuff, and they want some advice on, like, the process that somebody else uses. My process typically is when I write a script, I keep everything into paragraphs that I want to record in one take. So, for example, I won't separate the paragraphs on the script based on a topic. I separate them based on how long I want each recording to take. Because obviously, it's not smart to just read this entire thing in one take when I'm recording. It's smart to read a section of it so that if I fuck up, I just have to redo that section. So when I type out the script, I type it out into a certain size paragraph. And once I feel like it's long enough, I'm like, okay, that's like one take that I need to worry about, and we'll move on. So that's why you see my recording here is all cut up. This isn't because I did any editing. So down here is the audio I have for my for the video. And the reason it's all cut up is not because I cut it up myself. It's because that's how I recorded it. Each one of these recordings down here represents one paragraph or one section of the script. So the reason this is easy is because if I'm like, okay, if I'm writing the script, right? Let's say I'm writing the script and in paragraph 5, I want to put in a note that's like, okay, when you're saying this during the video, put up a picture or a clip of this. That way, when I'm editing now, I could be like, okay, I see in paragraph 5 that it says to do this. So I need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And during this paragraph, that's when I'm going to be saying that part of the script. So that's a little tip, I guess. So this gameplay of FM is actually totally unrelated. Pretty much when I make a video like this, there's really not that much to show you guys as far as gameplay is concerned. Most of it is just going to be screenshots. So I typically just will have some random FM gameplay of mine that I recorded at some point. But funnily enough, today, when I went to put random, you know, gameplay footage just to have in the background of the video, I didn't have any because I actually have my hard drive, my storage hard drive, unplugged. Now, on my storage hard drive, I have hundreds of hours of my own gameplay, Forbidden Memories, already saved. And when I say gameplay, I mean like just the game and the game audio. Because when I'm streaming, right, I have the game, I have face cam, I have chat, I have donations, all that shit, right? But it's also helpful to have recordings of just the game and the game audio on its own without anything else, so that when I'm making a video like this, I can use it. Unfortunately, like I said, I have hundreds of hours of that recorded, because most of the live streams that I do, I'm also recording the game footage separately. But I have that unplugged right now, so I actually just had to boot up FM and play it for 10. I looked at how long my audio was, and then I just figured I would record like a minute or two extra of gameplay, just random gameplay, and I had to do that tonight, so I just played this tonight. I did it on my Hundo file. I didn't save after that though, so it's fine because none of the progress I made got saved. So this video is going to be titled Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories Dual Ranks Guide. Okay, so this video is going to talk about how rank works in Forbidden Memories. So I know that a lot of people don't actually understand how rank works 100%. I think that there are a small amount of people who have no idea how rank works. These are the people who are like, GFC, you have a better chance of winning Meteor B Dragon on S-POW than you do on A-POW, which is totally wrong, right? Those people really don't understand rank. So those people really need this video. Then there's people who do understand rank a little bit, but they don't really understand how it works. This is what I would classify 99% of people like. So 99% of Forbidden Memories players, they know how rank works to the extent of they know, okay, if I get an S POW or an A POW, I can win one of these cards. If I get an S tech or an A tech, I can win one of these cards. And if I get any of the other ranks, I can win one of these cards. but they don't know how it exactly it works. And honestly, there's seven people watching right now. You seven might not actually know how rank works entirely, so this video might help you. For those of you who don't know, the way rank is actually calculated in Forbidden Memories is that there is a hidden number in the game. Yes, there is a hidden value that you can't see, but the game's code can see, right? And it's called rank points. At least that's what I call them. I call them rank points. There's no actual name for them, but as of this video, there is now a name for it. They're called rank points, goddammit. And pretty much those rank points, you start a duel at 50, and during the duel, it will either add or subtract from that 50. And then at the end of the duel, the game looks at that value and says, okay, you had 92 rank points, so you get an S-POW. Right, and it works like if you have between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S-POW. If you have between 80 and 89, you'll get an A-POW. And it goes all the way down to S-Tech, which is between 0 and 9. So since you're starting at 50, that means if you want to get a POW rank, you want to do things that are going to add to your rank points. And if you want a Tech rank, you want to do things that are going to subtract. In this video, I go over all that. Yeah, Red Hot's an outlier. He knows what's going on. So, really quick, oh yeah, and then over here, if you're wondering what these are outtakes. Because, so, I typically am pretty decent at speaking. Like, typically I'm pretty okay at speaking, right? Like, during a live stream, I don't stumble over my words that much, right? I can typically articulate thoughts pretty well, pretty eloquently, but when I'm recording a script, I am fucking horrible. I have to do take after take of some of these. I know these all say take one. Trust me, they're not take one. It just says that. So there is always outtakes, but typically I just delete them. Some of them have always been pretty funny too, but I typically just delete them. But this time I saved two outtakes because I just thought they were funny for some reason. There's this one. I don't know what this one is.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it so you don't have to.
My name is Markiplier, and I remember it so you don't have to. So this was me. This is actually the end part of an outtake. I cut off part of it, but for some reason, when I was recording part of the script, I started to sound too uptight. Like, instead of sounding like this, I started to sound like this, and I was just like, I sound like an idiot, I sound like Markiplier. So then I was like, I did the Markiplier intro, but I accidentally added on the Nostalgia Critic intro, because the Nostalgia Critic is like, hello everybody, I'm the Nostalgia Critic, I remember it, so you don't have to. But Markiplier is always like, hello everybody, my name is Markiplier, and welcome back to Five Nights at Freddy's 13. Right, so I accidentally combined that to hello everybody, my name is Markiplier, I remember it so you don't have to, and I thought it was funny as shit. So I actually went through the trouble of combining their faces for this outtake, because that's just how much of a fucking moron I am, because I thought it was pretty funny. Is it funny? Not really, but I thought it was, so I made this. This is a combination of Nostalgia Critic and Markiplier. I combined this image of Markiplier and this image of Nostalgia Critic, and it gives you this. So I don't know how I'm gonna work this into the video, but I will somehow. We'll find a way. Anyways, that is one. That's one of the outtakes.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it so you don't have to.
I want to see that crossover.
And then there is this one. So at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. Fuck. I get really mad when I make mistakes like that. So that's genuine anger you just heard. I get really fucking angry when I'm recording voiceovers because I always fuck up in the dumbest ways. Like right there, I said reward. You get a reward. And it just infuriates me. I don't know why. But we got the video. The video is going to be like 8.5 minutes, maybe 9 minutes with an outro. Because this is all the voiceovers right here. The voiceovers alone are around 8 minutes. So add in the bloopers. By bloopers, I mean those two clips. And my outro. Maybe 9 minutes. But I guess just to give everybody a sneak peek, I'm going to play the audio now. So if you guys want to hear the video before I start making it, I'm going to play through it now. Honestly, mainly because I need to listen to it anyway. Because typically when I record these, I listen to like this segment, right? I record this segment, then I listen back to it, and I'm like, okay, that's good, next. And then I move on. But I don't actually listen. You need to listen to all of it together to hear how it kind of flows and stuff. Now, I am going to have to move around the audio because there's going to be parts where there's title cards with no audio. So this is just all the audio cut together. But yeah, I need to listen to it. So you guys are going to listen to it too. So like I said, this video is going to be titled Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories Dual Ranks Guide. So this is going to be a guide on how rank works in Forbidden Memories. All right, so that is the title of the video. This footage is completely random footage of just me playing Forbidden Memories. It has nothing to do with anything I'm saying. So let me listen to this now, and you guys can listen too. So let's hear it. Hey, everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm going to explain how dual... Hey, everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm... Hang on a second, I need to pull up the script. I need to make sure I actually stuck to it. Any mistakes? I made a couple changes while I was recording, but yeah. All right, here we go. Hey, everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm going to explain how dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank. Duel and a random card as a reward. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and TECH ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent and slapped them into the dirt. Nice. Yeah, that's really good English, GFC. Good English. See, this is why we listen back to our voiceovers, chat. Because you have shit like that. I'm gonna make a fucking mixtape with this. This is why we listen back, ladies and gentlemen. Slap them in the dirt. Speak, boy, speak! Oh, that was a long take, too. That was a really long take as well. That sucks. Hang on, I'm just going to cut out that part.
The two different types of ranks, POW ranks and TECH ranks.
In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent and slapped them in the dirt. Nice.
Nice.
All right, I'm going to re-record that part. Okay. I need to kind of just fuck off over here and record it over here. All right. I need to re-record that. I'm so fucking mad that I do, but I have to. Gotta get situated here. I didn't think I'd have to re-record anything, honestly, but I do, so. Alright. I'm gonna take that fucking... I need to rewrite that. Means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. I like that. Can do it. Alright. Let's record this. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks. POW ranks and tech ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat Fuck! Speak clearly, boy! Alright, here we go. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and tech ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. I like that. That was a good take. I'm happy about that. Alright, here we go. First, calm down there, bucko. Alright, issue is that this is louder than all the other recordings. Crank the gain down a little bit on that. This isn't gonna fit, is it? Did that fit perfectly? No, it didn't. Fuck you. No, it didn't. Did that actually fit perfectly? It did. Oh my god, dude. Well, let's get in. First, let's talk about the two different and what rank you get. Well, let's get in. First, let's talk. Well, let's get in. Hello? Is this overlapping? It is. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. Okay. Rank you get. Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of rank.
Oh, hang on, I need to...
But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and tech ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel where you used more utility cards, used more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want it?
I kind of stumbled a little bit there. Did you guys catch that? Oh, hey, Tenzai. No, I remember you. You were here earlier. I stumbled a little bit there. I don't know if you guys heard it.
Please take longer than POW duels.
POW duels. I don't know. It just sounds like I stumbled.
Etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take...
Actually, I could probably just do something like this.
...longer than POW duels.
Let's do like this. Something like that.
These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S-Tech or A-Tech. You win a card from the second list if your rank was S-POW or A-POW. And finally, you win a card from the third list if you got any other rank. So B, C, or D, POW and Tech ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both S-POW and A-POW ranks, or on both S-TECH and A-TECH ranks. There's been some misinformation regarding the ranks in Forbidden Memories. Let's take Metal Mage as an example. Some people claim that if you want to win Meteor B Dragon from Metal Mage, you have a better chance on the S-POW rank rather than the A-POW rank. This is totally untrue. Like I just explained, S-POW and A-POW have the exact same drops at the exact same odds. So there's absolutely no difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S-POW. Okay, so we know how what cards you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got, but how does the game calculate what rank you get? Let's look into it. In Forbidden Memories, there's a hidden value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with 50 rank points. As you go through the duel, every action you perform will either add or subtract from your 50 rank points. Then, at the end of the duel, the game checks how many rank points you have and it assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S-POW. If you end with between 80 and 89 rank points, you'll get an A-POW, and so on, all the way down to S-TECH, which is between 0 and 9 rank points. So, because of this, if you want POW ranks, you want to perform actions that add rank points. And if you want tech ranks, you want to perform actions that subtract rank points. There are many ways to either add or subtract rank points from your total. Things such as how many fusions you do, how many magics or equips you use, how many cards you use, how many turns the duel takes, all change how many rank points you end up with. I'll include all of the ways to change your rank points in the description, but for the rest of the video, I'm going to go over each of them individually just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go. First off, there's the victory condition variable. Most duels will be total annihilation, which basically means you won the duel normally by lowering your opponent's life points to zero. Victory by attrition means your opponent ran out of cards, and Exodia win. Hang on a second, I want to make sure about something. This is really stupid, but I want to make sure of it first. Give me a second.
Attrition.
Means your opponent ran. Victory by attrition. Attrition. Hello? Did I say attrition. By attrition. By attrition. 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 Victory by attrition. Victory by. Attrition means attrition, 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 attrition,
attrition.
Yeah, that's right. Sounds weird when you break it up like that because I kind of fumbled my words into each other. I was like, victory by attrition, by a. So that's why it kind of sounds weird, but that's how sentences work, so that's okay. All right, Tenzai, take care. I will try to have fun editing. Editing is my least favorite part of the video. When I make videos, editing is my least favorite part of it. Like, this part, least favorite. Hate doing it. Don't like it at all. Which sucks, because the editing is what takes most of the time. Scripting, research, and voiceover recording, the amount of time all of that takes is like 1/5 of how long it takes to actually edit it into a video. And that stuff is the fun stuff, but whatever. Alright, let's go. By lowering your opponent's life points to 0. Victory by attrition means your opponent ran out of cards. An Exodia win means you drew all 5 pieces of Exodia, which instantly wins you the duel. As you can see, victory by attrition subtracts 40 rank points, which is a ton. This is why you almost always get the S-Tech rank when you deck your opponent out. Next is how many turns the duel took. Pretty self-explanatory, just count up how many turns the duel took, and add or subtract however many rank points correspond to that number of turns. As you can see, the more turns a duel takes, the more rank points you lose, which pushes you closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks. Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some explanation. Basically, an effective
Wait a second. So I think it was at the end of this recording that Bubba actually jumped up somewhere and he made noise. And I was going to redo it, but I wanted to keep it in. I think if you listen closely, you can hear it.
You closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks.
Yeah, it's like right here.
Longer than power ranks.
Like right here.
Power rank. Power rank. Longer than power ranks. Longer than power ranks. Longer than power ranks. Longer than power ranks.
You can hear it in the background.
Longer than power ranks. Longer than power ranks. Longer than power ranks.
Like right here-ish.
Ranks. 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 Ranks.
That's Bubba jumping up somewhere, if anyone was wondering. Alright, let's continue.
Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some explanation. Basically, an effective attack is when you attack and destroy a card and do life point damage at the same time. For example, if you attack a Blue Eyes White Dragon that's in attack mode with a Meteor B Dragon, you'll destroy it and you'll do 500 life point damage. That's an effective attack. Note that this means suiciding your monster does not count as an effective attack, since you don't do life point damage. So, for example, if you attack a Meteor B Dragon with your own Meteor B Dragon, both monsters will be destroyed, and it will not count as an effective attack. Next are defensive wins. You get a defensive win if the opponent tries to attack one of your monsters that's in defense mode, but they don't destroy it and they take damage in the process. For example, if you play Millennium Shield in defense mode and your opponent tries to attack it with a Dark Magician, your shield will not be destroyed and your opponent will take 500 damage. That is a defensive win. Just like with effective attacks, this means that if the opponent does not take life point damage when they try attacking, it will not count as a defensive win. The next few are pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just going to go through them quickly. First, we have face down plays, which just means playing any card face down. Next, we have initiate fusion, which just means performing a successful fusion. Next is equip magic, which just means successfully using any equip card. And finally, there's pure magic, which means using any magic card, such as Regeki or Umi. Next is trigger trap, which just means you have to play a trap card and it successfully activates. Note how I mentioned the trap has to actually activate for it to count. Just playing it doesn't count. You have to play it and then have your opponent activate it. For example, playing Widespread Ruin face down does not count as a trap being used just yet, but once your opponent tries attacking you and Widespread Ruin destroys their monster, that's when it counts as a triggered trap. The next variable is cards used. This just means how many cards you drew during the duel. So, for example, if you have 27 cards left, that means you use 13 cards, so you'd get 0 rank points. And finally, the last variable is remaining LP, which is just how many life points you have remaining at the end of the duel. And that's all of them. As you go through the duel, you can keep track of all of these things and figure out how many rank points are being added or subtracted from your starting 50 points, and then you can figure out what rank you'll get. Really quick, I just want to mention how this information was obtained. Believe it or not, all of this information I gave in this video was published in the official Japanese guide for Forbidden Memories. For years, we didn't fully understand how rank worked, and the answer was in the official Japanese guide the entire time. Go figure. That's basically everything. Big thanks to Infamous888 for posting this rank chart on NeoSeeker. I plan on eventually releasing another video that shows off the best methods to get certain ranks, such as A-Tech or B-Pow, so keep an eye out for those soon. I have lots of useful information, including the entire rank points chart, in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it so you don't have to.
I want to see that crossover.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. A reward. A reward.
A reward. You get the reward. You beat the duel. You get the card. You get the reward.
Y'all like my little blooper section? Y'all like my outtakes? Y'all getting wet at my outtakes? Y'all pussies salivating at my outtakes? Y'all vaginas self-lubricating at the auditory stimulation of my outtakes? Alright, the audio is good, the voiceovers are done, leave me alone. From now on, we don't need to give any sort of a shit about audio. So audio's done, other than some music or something. I'll probably have some shit. Don't worry about it. Figure that out later. Alright, so voiceover's done. All of this sounds good enough. There's some parts that are like, but fine. It's just how I sound, unfortunately. How did I get Markiplier into the video? I just asked him. I said, Markiplier, can you take 5 seconds out of your day to help an aspiring up-and-coming YouTuber? And he said,
"Durr, Five Nights at Freddy, durr."
And I said, okay, Mark. And then he helped me. Inspiring, really. I'm for music. Installing? Hello? What do you mean installing? Oh! Everything just crashed. No, wait, no, it didn't. Everything just decided to be dumb, I guess. Time to listen to acapella music for the next 5 years.
As a child, you would wait and watch from far.
All right, let's get to it. reproduce this fucking file? Where is it? Wait. Where is it?
I love the urine folder. That's a good folder, chat. Dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranked for that duel and a random card rank. You win a duel, you're given a.
Okay, that's not looking too good. Paint time. Only because I really don't feel like opening up fucking Photoshop at the moment. You know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random.
Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden
Memories,
what's up,
MLG Gamer?
You know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward.
Welcome to video editing. It sucks.
Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank.
Yeah, I guess I'll just turn up Photoshop now. I use Sony Vegas, Nate. Combination of Sony Vegas and Photoshop. I think that people underestimate how needed Photoshop is to make a video. I'm not talking about making like a thumbnail. I'm talking about like how important it is to have a photo editing program just for videos themselves, because I use so many pictures during my videos, and now they're gonna complain to me on how I never bought Photoshop, because who the fuck would ever do that? And then I just have to go into Task Manager and close out of their authenticity thing, and then it will never bother me again today. You gotta go in here, see this? Adobe Genuine Software Integrity Service? You gotta get out of that. Genuine Software Service, get out of that. Now it won't bother me anymore. Isn't that fun? Which version of Sony Vegas? I personally use 14. Vegas Pro 14. But you can use any version of Sony Vegas. There's much newer versions of Sony Vegas, but I just don't have a need to update. I obviously didn't buy it either. I mean, come on. Sony Vegas Pro costs like $1,000. I mean, obviously. No, I mean, most people don't. Most people don't do that. Most people just torrent it. So just torrent it. I'm gonna be real here. Most content creators aren't gonna tell you that. I'll tell you that. 99% of content creators are torrenting their shit. Because nobody's spending $1,000 on Sony Vegas. Nobody. At least nobody on YouTube is. So what did I want to do? New... 20, 1080, background transparent. It fucking... Not for me.
memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank all the way up to rank for that duel and a random card as a reward? The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank?
I keep forgetting to fucking think. Hang on.
Card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does
Yeah, I use Vegas.
Bit of memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game... The rank you get ranges... You're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, determine what rank you get. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine...
I'm an idiot. I just remembered something. Fuck. Here's a tip for making videos. If you're ever going to put text on the screen, fucking put an outline, fucking put the stroke effect on it. Don't be a dickhead. Put stroke effect over it. Okay? Thanks. Always put the stroke effect over your text. Because if you don't, it looks like shit. Always put the stroke effect on your text. I was wondering why it looked like such shit. Look at how much better that looks already.
Duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. And what rank?
I need to do something funny here. Now this is what I call being lazy right now. Actually, no, I won't be lazy. I'll do it the right way. Yeah, I'm not going to make it spin, but I will do this. Oh, but I only wanted to do it for a second. Fuck, hang on a second. I just fucked up. I didn't want to do it for the whole time. Okay, yeah, like this. All right, yeah, this is what I had in mind, so watch.
Card is a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
Yeah, just a little flicker of it.
Game determine what rank you get. Well, let's get into it.
Much better.
But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. Get into it. How does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
First,
rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
First,
you get. Well, let's get into it.
This random audio, random nothingness. Cool. All right. So now what we need to do is pretty much take all of the audio. Select it all, and just tell it to fuck off for now. So what we're gonna do is select all of the audio. We're gonna right click, and we are going to group and create new. So now all of this audio is added as a group, and the reason why I want to do that is so I can do this. But all at once. I will have to remove it from a group once I want to do shit with it, but typically what I'll do is this will keep everything grouped, so as I make the video, as I need more audio, I can remove like this piece from the group and then move it over, but I can still move around everything else. Very useful. If you're ever making videos, remember, always add all of your audio takes, all of your audio cuts together in a group, and then remove each bit from the group as you need it in the video. Because after I say this, there's going to be a period where there's no voiceover because I'm going to have a title card. So I need there to be space between this, which means I need to move all this over. So then maybe somewhere around here, I want the audio to come back in. But maybe I'll have another title card after this one. So we'll remove these three from the group, move them over to here, and then we can still move around the rest. So, yeah, that's my recommendation. All right, so we need to make a title card. I have the titles saved in my script. I just need to see what they're called. Drop pools, okay.
You get. Well, let's get into it. Well, let's get into it.
Same to your fucking video. You just delete this audio because we're never going to use the game audio. Don't do whatever you just did there.
How does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
So I want about 4 seconds of it. I'm going to do this. And... oh, now that I don't know what just happened there. So I'm gonna use this footage for my for a backdrop of my title card. So pretty much it's gonna be like, let's get into it, and then it will fade to black. It's gonna stay black for a second, then this is going to fade in, and then for 4 seconds there's gonna be the title card, which will fade out, and this footage will be behind the title card but blurred. So we need to blur this. I've never actually done this in a video before, so I don't actually know how to easily just blur it, but I'm guessing it's just going to be this. Blur, 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 blur. Where is my fucking blur? Maybe add noise. Vegas film effects. Here we go. Yeah. Just like that, baby. Just like that. A bit less. Okay, so, yeah, so what we're gonna do here... gonna be like this, so...
well, let's get into it.
Out to black, title card, back down into the video. So now we need to put a title card on top of that, so... this. Centered. Okay. Save as G part one.
Well, let's get into it.
There's going to be background music this whole time, by the way. Let me grab that now so that this feels a little bit better. Gotta find... I have the free dual music saved somewhere. Actually, let's use like pepper steak.
Mm-hmm.
Hey everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm going to explain how dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
I actually kind of like that in the background.
But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
Maybe something like this. So let's see how this flows so far. Let's see how it flows.
Hey everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm going to explain how dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
Let's make the music, like, get louder here. So, like this. So you split it there. You split it here. So then what you do is, between here and here, I'll make it gradually get louder. Then I'll have it stay constant, and then get softer, back into the background. Do that. How do I do this again? I forget how to do this. Hang on.
Hey guys, this is Steven, and today I'm going to be showing you how to adjust your volume or your audio levels.
This is another thing I do in video editing a lot because, I mean, nobody knows how to do everything in Sony Vegas or in any video editing program, so in pretty much every video I've ever made, I've had to look up how to do something because I just forgot. I've done this in videos before, but I forget how exactly to do it again.
In Sony Vegas. It's going to look a little bit something like this, where you can adjust your levels, and it'll transition the audio wave smoothly. So what we need to do, simply click the audio and hit the V key. This will bring up the audio volume adjuster. And all we have to do is double click wherever we want on the point on our timeline. And then
that's it. Okay, V. Undo that again. Up there.
So maybe something like that?
What rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different...
Kind of like that, except it needs to get a little bit louder. Bring that fucker... High she goes. So, like this.
But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types.
I wish...
Hey, everybody, it's GFC.
There was more of, like, a difference. I guess it kind of works.
And today I'm going to explain how dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different... Well, let's get into it.
That's good.
First, let's talk about the two different types of
ranks. That's perfect. That's actually pretty good. That's better than most... That's better quality than most of my videos get. We actually have, like, a title card. We have background music that stays consistent but gets louder during when it should and softer when it should. That was pretty cool, actually. I like that. Listen to that again and watch it over here.
The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks.
I like that. I think that that looks good. I think that sounds good. I'm happy with that. I'm actually quite happy with how this is looking so far. Keep in mind, we've only edited about 28 seconds of the video, so, yeah. But, it'll get easier from here, hopefully.
Power ranks and tech ranks. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks. Power ranks.
Wait.
And tech ranks.
Time to steal a picture from Google and just rip part of it out.
How's chat doing tonight?
To S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and tech ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magic. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, Bucko.
Oh my god, that is not a transparent image. Holy shit on a biscuit. You lied to me. You told me it was transparent, but you lied.
and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, Bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel where you used more utility. Nice job, Bucko. Overpowered your opponent. Nice job, Bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically. Your opponent. Nice job, Bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks. Typically mean you had a longer duel where you used more utility cards, fused more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take more, took more damage, etc. You flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, Bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel where you used more utility cards, fused more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Take longer. Why would you ever want to do them?
I'm gonna reuse a meme.
So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them?
Oh,
More, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories...
Alright, so I'm pretty sure... this is the point. I think this is where I have another title card. Yeah, calculating dual rank. There's three title cards that we'll be using. I want to do the same kind of deal that I did the first time. The audio and everything else, so Where's the band list? Where is it? Tell me now. Tell me now. Perfect. So this is the same sizes that I have over here. So the way that the last transition worked is that there was 1 full second of black screen. Then we fade in to the title card, which stays for exactly 4 seconds. And then 1 full second after that. And that's what I just placed the markers from. So from here to here is 1 second. Then from here to here is 4. And then from here to here is another 1 second. So this will stay blank, and during this time, the audio will come up, then the audio will stay up, the background music will stay loud for this 4 seconds, this is where the title card goes, and then we bring the audio back down here, and then the video continues right here. I'm doing good, this is actually going quite smoothly so far, not too editing intensive yet. And it's not really going to be too intensive, but yeah. So we want to add this here. Out. Want eat. Split. Split, and then we want to go split, and then we want to go poopy poopoo here. Actually, I want to go back into here really quick. Save that preset, so now I can go over here. I can add in again. Load the preset. Perfect. Now we're just going to do the same thing with the audio. We are going to Alright, let's see how this looks and sounds. Apart from like here.
Tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel, where you used more utility cards, used more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than power duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question.
Yep, and then we'll go back into it right there. I actually like how it cuts to black immediately there. I kind of want to do that for the first one. I want to see how that looks on the first one.
E rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it.
I kind of like how it just goes right to black like that.
First, let's talk about the two different types of rank. If tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question.
Alright, let's see how this looks, sounds,
so,
everything.
If tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories...
Cut that a bit.
Longer than power duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward.
Good. That's awesome. Looking good, boys! Whoa, yeah. Also, I need to figure out, because this music isn't long enough, but it should be able to loop, so I should be able to just plaster it there again. But I want to hear it.
Pow and tech ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both.
I should be able to just continue this. Like the entire video, and it should sound fine.
This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both S-Pow and
yeah.
A-P.
Yeah, see, it loops. Listen, here, I can mute this really quick. Yeah, so listen to the music here. Wait, start it like here. This is the end of the song, but listen. It's in the background, so it'll be hard to notice. Now let's listen to the audio going up and down, which I'm quite proud of. That's good, that's juicy. I like it.
So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card. Get a card as a reward.
I'm reusing images like a fiend. Except this time. Zoom on in on it.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from.
Alright, I'm gonna need to do a lot more Photoshop now. Starting now until the end of the video, there's a lot of Photoshopping I need to do and screenshotting and things like that. I'm gonna have to make these smaller.
That is working. I know. Are you proud of me? Are you proud of your dad? He's working to put bread on the table, bud. He's working to put treats in your bowl. Yeah. Bubba, I am doing this so that I can buy you all of the yummy treats. Tuna, whitefish, chicken, turkey. You like all those things? Yeah? Well, this is all for you, buddy. Yeah. All the money this video makes, I buy you treats with it. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Dad works for you. Yeah. That's what he does. Dad works for you. You can be a happy fat boy. Yes. Yes.
He's a happy little man. Doobadoo boom ba da doom ba doom boom ba doom boom ba da doom ba doom boom ba doom boom ba da doom ba doom ba da doom boom ba da doom ba doom ba doom boom ba doom boom boom ba doom boom boom ba doom boom ba doom boom doom 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 boom boom. Do 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 do.
That's better. Why does this not have like a center, like a normal fucking... Alright, that's better. Alright, now we need to see how this actually looks on a video. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are... are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. Thank you, God. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S. From one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S-Tech or A-Tech. First list if your rank was S-Tech or A-Tech. You win a card from the second list if your rank was... was S POW or A POW, and finally you win a card from the third list if you got
any other rank. So B, C, or D, POW and tech ranks.
All right. And then when you put that together, it looks like this, chat.
On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S-Tech or A-Tech. You win a card from the second list if your rank was S-POW or A-POW. And finally, you win a card from the third list if you got any other rank. So B, C, or D, POW and tech ranks.
That works so well, dude. Hell yeah. That's one of my favorite, I guess, tricks to use when making videos. Is if you want, like, part of the text to show up at certain times. So, like, say I make a picture like this, but I only want, like, I want there to be one part of the video where it only shows the list, like, titles, and then, like, this comes in at one part, this comes in at another. My favorite trick for doing that easily is to just make the finished product and then just hide the layers in Photoshop and save each iteration and then mark in the video, in the audio, where you want each iteration to go, and then number the pictures and save them all, like 1, 2, 3, 4, like I did, and then just toss them in. It's a really good trick for video editing, and it produces stuff like this very, very easily. So yeah, I'm happy with that section.
Or D, POW and tech ranks. This means that you...
Perfect. Now it should sound a little bit better.
So B, C, or D, POW and tech ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both S-POW and A-POW ranks, or...
Gonna show your magazine as well? My magazine? What do you mean, my magazine? Oh, you mean the Japanese guide? Probably not, no. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll show a screenshot of it. Probably not, no. I'm going to be showing screenshots from the Neo Seeker guide a lot.
B, C, or D POW and tech ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both. S POW and A POW ranks, or on both the exact same odds on both S POW and A POW ranks, or on both S Tech and A Tech ranks. There's been some misinformation regarding the ranks in Forbidden Memories. Let's take Metal Mage as an example. Some people claim that if you want to win Meteor B Dragon from Metal Mage, you have a better chance on the S POW rank rather than the A POW rank. This is totally untrue. Like I just explained, S POW and A POW have the untrue. Like I just explained. S POW and A POW have the exact same drops at the exact same odds. So there's absolutely no difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S POW. Okay, so we. One extra star chip on S POW. You get one extra star chip on S POW. No difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S POW. Okay, so we know how what card you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got. But how does the game calculate what rank you get? Let's look into it.
So 236.24, so we want to go to 237.24. Okay. Now we want to go to 4 seconds, so 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. So 241.24. And now we want to go to 242.24. Good enough. All right. So this will be another title card. So now what we do is we go here and we go split, and then we go here and we go split, and then we remove the boop boop. Then we go here, and we go split, and then we go here, and we go split, because this is going to be another title card. And then we remove the boo-boo. And then we go here, and we add in our wonderful blur effect. Use our preset. We add in the fade in, we add in the fade out,
Split and split. All right, so now it should do the audio thing.
Look into it.
God, I love me.
No difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S-Pal. Okay, so we know how what card you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got. But how does the game calculate what rank you get? Let's look into it. In Forbidden Memories, there's a hidden...
God, I love myself so much sometimes. I am not half bad at this. God damn, this video's turning out sweet. Wait.
Why would you ever want to do them? Great question.
Wait.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duel...
First one called. Hang on a second.
First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and tech ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW...
Okay, I just realized I made a mistake on everything. Not everything, but I need to change all of the title cards, because I moved them all over one on accident. This needs to be part one. Part two needs to be drop pools. All right, so that should just automatically update over here.
Card is a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and tech ranks.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel where you used more utility cards, fused more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S-Tech or A-Tech. You win a card from the second list if your rank was S-Pow or A-Pow. And finally, you win a card from the third list if you got any other rank, so B, C, or D, Pow and Tech ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both S-Pow and A-Pow ranks, or on both S-Tech and A-Tech ranks. There's been some misinformation regarding the ranks in Forbidden Memories. Let's take Metal Mage as an example. Some people claim that if you want to win Meteor B Dragon from Metal Mage, you have a better chance on the S-Pow rank rather than the A-Pow rank. This is totally untrue. Like I just explained, S-Pow and A-Pow have the exact same drops at the exact same odds. So there's absolutely no difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S-Pow. Okay, so we know how what cards you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got.
Alright, that's perfect. That's what I want. And then part 3 is going to be rank points, and then part 4, the final part, will be rank variables. That's what I meant to do. I just got it a little mixed up because it was wrong in my notes. Easy fix, though. Alright, so it should look good now. Pow.
Okay, so we know how what card you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got. But how does the game calculate what rank you get? Let's look into it. In Forbidden Memories, there's a hidden value called rank point.
Perfect. Alright, let's keep going then. Oh, wait a second. Oh no, it's good, right? That has the outline on it? Yeah, it has the outline. Okay, good.
In Forbidden Memories, there is a hidden value called... rank points. When you start a duel, you... there's a hidden value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with 50... value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with... with 50 rank points. As you go through the duel, every action you perform will either add... every action you perform will either add or subtract from your 50 rank points. Hidden value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with 50 rank points. As you go through the duel, every action you perform will either add or subtract from your 50 rank points. Then, at the end of the duel, the game checks how many rank points you have and it assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with... between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S pal. Thank you.
Yo, what's up, Eric Scott? How you doing, brother? Welcome to Video Editing 101 with somebody who makes really bad videos. Rank points you have, and it assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S pow. If you end with between 80 and 89 rank points, you'll get an A pow. See how this works.
Assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S pow. If you end with between 80 and 89 rank points, you'll get an A pow, and so on, all the way down to S pow. All the way down to S-Tech, which is between 0 and 9 rank points.
Oh no, Feral. Good luck. Alright, let's see how this looks all together. Here we go. Well, let's start off at the transition and see how this all looks.
We're almost halfway done.
What rank you get. Let's look into it. In Forbidden Memories, there's a hidden value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with 50 rank points. As you go through the duel, every action you perform will either add or subtract from your 50 rank points. Then, at the end of the duel, the game checks how many rank points you have and it assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S-Pow. If you end with between 80 and 89 rank points, you'll get an A-Pow, and so on, all the way down to S-Tech, which is between 0 and 9 rank points. So, because of this, if you want POW ranks, you want to perform actions that add rank points. And if you want tech ranks, you want to perform... So, because of this, if you want... On POW ranks, you want to perform actions that add... add rank points. And if you want... on POW ranks, you want to...
Hey Camille, I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. It's been a good stream so far. Just working.
All the way down to S-Tech, which is between 0 and 9 rank points. So, because of this, if you want POW ranks, you want to perform actions that add rank points. And if you want tech points, and if you want that add rank points, and if you want tech ranks, you want to perform actions that subtract rank points. There are many ways to either add or subtract rank points from your total. Things such as how many fusions you do, how many magics or equips you use, how many cards you use, how many turns the duel takes, all change how many rank points you end up with. I'll include all of the ways to change your rank points in the description, but for the rest of the video, I'm going to go over each of them individually just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go.
All right, so this last part of the video is probably going to take the longest. That's okay.
Alright, so same as always, we want to add one full second, so 359.27. Enough. Now 4 seconds onto that, so 59, 40, 401, 402, so 403.29. Now 404.29. Okay, and now we want to go here. Split over here. Zoom in a bit. Split. Take this. Go pee pee over here. Split over here. Split. Go beep beep. Go here. Video effects. Blur. Add. Okay. Preset. Bam. Good. For audio, we want to do like this. And this up like that there. Back down. Hello? Can you guys hear me? Hello, hello, hello. You can hear me? Okay, good. Just checking. Go here, refresh, part 4, here, then put it in between the boundaries, a bit more, put in some fade offset, fade in, out, and we should have another transition, ladies and gentlemen. Oh wait, not yet. We gotta put the audio back over yonder. Alright, we should have another transition. Let's see.
To change your rank points in the description. But
I'm getting really good at these transitions, at making them quickly.
Just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go. First off, there's the victory condition variable. Most duels...
I like it. We just need to cut off some of this,
individually, just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go. First off, there's the victory condition variable. Most duels will be total annihilation.
Alright, so this is where we're just gonna have to take a shit ton of screenshots. So I'm going to open up the NeoSeeker thread. Alright, and we are just gonna take a shit ton of screenshots real quick.
Give me a second. I need to take a bunch of screenshots. OBS just did the same thing again, but I'm assuming it's fine because it said it reconnected, so I don't know why that's happening, but let's just pretend it's not. All right, all the screenshots are taken. It was 11. I needed 11 of them. So this part will hopefully be quick. Most of the hard shit with the video should be done by now. So the rest of this should be pretty quick now.
First off, there's the victory condition variable. The victory condition variable. Most duels will be total annihilation, which basically means you won the duel normally by lowering your opponent's life points to zero. Victory by attrition means your opponent ran out of cards. An Exodia win means you drew all five pieces of Exodia, which instantly wins you the duel. As you can see, victory by attrition subtracts 40 rank points, which is a ton. This is why you almost always get the S-Tech rank when you deck your opponent out.
That one to that one. Refresh this. I put a variables thing. The one is victory condition. How's this gonna look?
Individually, just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go. First off, there's the victory condition variable. Most duels will be total annihilation, which basically means you won the duel normally by lowering your opponent's life points to zero. Victory by attrition means your opponent ran out of cards. An Exodia win means you drew all five pieces of Exodia, which instantly wins you the duel. As you can see, victory by attrition subtracts 40 rank points, which is a ton. This is why you almost always get the S-Tech rank when you deck your opponent out. Turns the duel took. Pretty self-explanatory, just count up how many turns the duel took and add or subtract however many rank points correspond to that number of turns. As you can see, the more turns a duel takes, the more rank points you lose, which pushes you closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks. Next up are effects. Points you lose, which pushes you closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks. Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some explanation. Basically, an effective attack is when you attack and destroy a card and do life point damage at the same time. For example, if you attack a Blue-Eyes White Dragon that's in attack mode with a Meteor B-Dragon, you'll destroy it and you'll do 500 life point damage. That's an effective attack. Note that this means suiciding your monster does not count as an effective attack, since you attack a Blue-Eyes White Dragon that's in attack mode with a Meteor B-Dragon, you'll destroy it and you'll do 500 life point damage. That's an effective attack. Note that this means
wait. Why did I forget what the ratio was again?
Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some explanation. Basically, an effective attack is when you attack and destroy a card and do life point damage at the same time. For example, if you attack a Blue-Eyes White Dragon that's in attack mode with a Meteor B-Dragon, you'll destroy it and you'll do 500 life point damage. That's an effective attack. Note that this means suiciding your monster does not... count as an effective attack, since you don't do life point damage. So, for example, if you attack a Meteor Bee Dragon with your own Meteor Bee Dragon, both monsters will be destroyed, and it will not count as an effective attack. Next are defenses.
Just about done, bubs.
Effective attack. Is an effective attack. Next are defensive attack. Next are
Oh, hi, Bubbo. Wanna take my seat? It's all yours.
It's all yours. It's all yours. You have earned the seat more than I have, I'll tell you that much.
I will take the poopy seat that nobody wants, apparently.
My cat's small? No, my cat is not small. My cat is a big boy.
He's a big boy, right? You're a fat boy.
Oh, yeah. He's such a good boy. I know you can barely see him. Oh, he's purring. Oh, he's happy.
Happy?
Yeah.
What, buddy? Being a good boy tonight? Boy tonight? Yeah? Gonna give you a big bowl of turkey-flavored wet food.
For being such a good boy once I'm done with this video, okay? Give me another... Not long, maybe another hour. Not even. Yeah, not even another hour. Another 30, 45 minutes and I'll be done, buddy. I'll be all done. Gosh. Been such a good boy while Dad is working. While Dad was working, you were taking a nap over there. You were in the same room as him. Being a good, supportive boy. Right?
Yeah.
My boy.
My boy. And my boy?
He is such a good boy. I'll tell you what, chat. I will tell you what. This boy that we have in front of us right now, he is the best boy.
Bubba, you are famous. Everyone loves you. There are people all around the world who love you. Just like they should. How does that feel, buddy? How does it feel?
know that you are more famous than most cats on Earth. You are loved by more people than most cats ever will be. Just by being your cute self. His eyes are like half closed at this point as he's enjoying the attention. Having a good time right now. Are you kneading, buddy? Are you making me some bread? Some invisible bread? Well, you're kneading it very well. Shedding a little bit. Because it's getting warmer, right? It's almost summertime. Shedding off all that fur. You got lots of it. Yeah. My good shedding boy. Finally, a streamer doesn't throw their cat across the room. Now, when Bubba comes in here, the stream stops and Bubba becomes top priority. Right, buddy? You're top priority. All the time. When I'm done with this video that I've been working on for hours and hours, and I make money from it, I'm gonna use that money to buy you lots of treats and toys. And I'll feed you them all the time and I'll play with you. It will be great. Cleaning himself now. Boy? Yeah? Alright. Clean boy. Mean boy. What are you thinking about, huh? You look tired. You look tired. I think he just wants pets now, then he wants some food, and then he wants to take a big nap. That's what I think he wants, right? I got very good at figuring out what you want. Yes, I did. Alright. Let's see if we can keep working. Yeah, Bubs? I'm gonna do my best to do it from here. You can just sit right there, okay? You just stay right there. I'll do my best. For you.
Defensive wins. You get a defensive win if the opponent tries to attack one of your monsters that's in defense mode, but they don't destroy it and they take damage in the process. For example, if you play Millennium Shield in defense mode and your opponent tries to attack...
The good part is that, The rest of the video is the same editing that I just did. Like, it's super quick. So, all of the hard parts are done. The rest of this video is going to be really fast to edit.
Attack it with a Dark Magician, your shield will not be destroyed, and your opponent will take 500 damage. That is a defensive win. Just like with effective attacks, this means that if the opponent does not take life point damage when they try attacking, it will not count as a defensive win. It will not count as a defensive win. The next few are pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just going to go through them quickly. First, we have face-down plays, which just means playing any card face-down. Next, we have initiate fusion, which just means performing a successful fusion. Fusion.
Next is equipment. Next is... is equip magic, which just means successfully using any equip card. And finally, there's pure magic, which means using any magic card, such as Regeki or Umi. Magic card such as Regeki or Umi. There's pure magic, which means using any magic card such as Regeki or Umi. Next is trigger Regeki or Umi. Next is trigger trap, which just means you have to play a trap card and it successfully activates. Note how I mentioned the trap has to actually activate for it to count. Just playing it doesn't count. You have to play it and then have your opponent activate it. For example, playing Widespread Ruin face down does not count as a trap being used just yet, but once your opponent tries attacking you and Widespread Ruin destroys their monster, that's when it counts as a trigger trap. Widespread Ruin destroys their monster, that's when it counts as a trigger trap. The next variable is when it counts as a trigger trap. And it will not count as an effective attack. Next are defensive wins. You get a defensive win if the opponent tries to attack one of your monsters. When they try attacking, it will not count as a defensive win. The next few are pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just going to go through them quickly. First, we have face down plays, which just means playing any card face down. Next, we have initiate fusion, which just means opponent tries attacking you and Widespread Ruin destroys their monster. That's when it counts as a trigger trap. S tech rank when you deck your opponent out. Next is how many turns get the S tech rank when you deck your opponent out. Next is how many turns the duel took.
See ya, Bubs.
Pretty self-explanatory. Just count up how many turns the duel took and add or subtract however many rank points correspond to that number of turns. As you can see, the more turns a duel takes, the more rank points you lose, which pushes you closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks. Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some... opponent tries attacking you and Widespread Ruin destroys their monster, that's when it counts as a trigger trap. The next variable is card variable is card cards used. This just means how many cards you drew during the duel. So, for example, if you have 27 cards left, that means you use 13 cards, so you'd get 0 rank points. And? Rank points. Zero rank points. And final. Get zero rank points. And finally, the last variable is remaining LP, which is just how many life points you have remaining at the end of the duel. The last variable is remaining LP, which is just how many life points you have remaining at the end of the duel. And that's all of them. As you go through the duel, you can keep track of all of these things and figure out how many rank points are being added or subtracted from your starting 50 points, and then you can figure out what rank you'll get. Really quick, I just want... want to mention how this information was obtained. Believe it or not, all of this information I gave in this video was published in the Believe it or not, all of this information I gave in this video was published in the official Japanese guide for Forbidden Memories. For years, we didn't fully understand how rank worked, and the answer was in the official Japanese guide the entire time. Go figure. That's basically everything. Big thanks to Infamous888 for posting this rank chart on NeoSeeker. I plan on eventually releasing another video that shows off the best methods to get certain ranks, such as A-Tech or B-Pow, so keep an eye out for those soon. I have lots of useful information, including the entire rank points chart, in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Just about done. Just about done. Just about done. Yeah. Yeah. Just about done, boyos. Done, boyo. Just about done, boyos. Boyos, boyos,
information, including the entire rank points chart, in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Outtakes in one word is correct? Okay. It didn't look right. I was gonna check it before I did anything, but yeah. God, that looks so wrong, doesn't it? That just looks bad, man. That looks so bad. But if it's right...
I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello, everybody. My name is...
entire rank points chart in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. A reward. A reward. Every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward.
A reward. A reward.
A reward. You get to reward. You get to do. You get to cut. You get the reward.
Fuck.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it, so you don't have to. Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it, so you don't have to. Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it, so you don't have to.
Alright, I think it's done. I'll see you next time. Bye bye. What's the point of including outtakes? I thought they were funny. That's what.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. A reward. A reward.
A reward. You get to reward. You get to do. You get to cut. You get to reward.
Fuck.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it, so you don't have to.
I want to see that crossover.
There were a lot more outtakes, obviously, but I just thought those two in particular were pretty epic.
During the duel. So, for example, if you have 20 POW, so keep an eye out for those soon. I have lots of useful information, including the entire rank points chart, in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.
Give me fade offset, cunt. Cunt. Right, cunt. Right, little cunt. Where's my fade offset, cunt? Fuck is it? I mean, I could just do this.
So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card.
Alright, I think it's time to watch it from the beginning and see what we got. So how long is the video exactly? It is 9 minutes on the dot. 9 minutes on the dot. Alright, let's check it out, chat. Let's watch the old video together, me and you, for the next 9 minutes. I'll give you kisses the whole time. Every minute on the minute. Maybe even every second. Alright, let's do it. I'm gonna mute myself. So let's watch the video in that little screen on the top right.
Hey everybody, it's GFC, and today I'm going to explain how dual ranks work in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. If you've ever played Forbidden Memories, you know that whenever you win a duel, you're given a rank for that duel and a random card as a reward. The rank you get ranges from D rank all the way up to S rank. But how does the game determine what rank you get? Well, let's get into it. First, let's talk about the two different types of ranks, POW ranks and TECH ranks. In short, if your rank ends in POW, it typically means you ended the duel somewhat quickly and without using lots of utility cards such as magics or traps. It means you flat out overpowered your opponent. Nice job, bucko. Alternatively, tech ranks typically mean you had a longer duel, where you used more utility cards, fused more, took more damage, etc. These duels will always take longer than POW duels. So, if tech ranks take longer, why would you ever want to do them? Great question. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. The cards you can win change depending on what rank you got. Think of it like this. On every duelist in Forbidden Memories, there are three different drop pools, or three different lists of cards you can potentially win from. Once you finish a duel, the game looks at what rank you got, and then it gives you a card from one of those three lists that correspond to the rank. You win a card from the first list if your rank was S Tech or A Tech. You win a card from the second list if your rank was S POW or A POW. And finally, you win a card from the third list if you got any other rank. So B, C, or D POW and TECH ranks. This means that you win the exact same cards at the exact same odds on both S POW and A POW ranks, or on both S TECH and A TECH ranks. There's been some misinformation regarding the ranks in Forbidden Memories. Let's take Metal Mage as an example. Some people claim that if you want to win Meteor B Dragon from Metal Mage, you have a better chance on the S POW rank rather than the A POW rank. This is totally untrue. Like I just explained, S POW and A POW have the exact same drops at the exact same odds. So there's absolutely no difference between the two, except you get one extra star chip on S POW. Okay, so we know how what card you get at the end of a duel corresponds to what rank you got, but how does the game calculate what rank you get? Let's look into it. In Forbidden Memories, there's a hidden value called rank points. When you start a duel, you start off with 50 rank points. As you go through the duel, every action you perform will either add or subtract from your 50 rank points. Then, at the end of the duel, the game checks how many rank points you have and it assigns you a rank. If you end the duel with between 90 and 99 rank points, you'll get an S POW. If you end with between 80 and 89 rank points, you'll get an A POW, and so on, all the way down to S Tech, which is between 0 and 9 rank points. So, because of this, if you want POW ranks, you want to perform actions that add rank points, and if you want Tech ranks, you want to perform actions that subtract rank points. There are many ways to either add or subtract rank points from your total. Things such as how many fusions you do, how many magics or equips you use, how many cards you use, how many turns the duel takes, all change how many rank points you end up with. I'll include all of the ways to change your rank points in the description, but for the rest of the video, I'm going to go over each of them individually just so you can understand what they all mean. Let's go. First off, there's the victory condition variable. Most duels will be total annihilation, which basically means you won the duel normally by lowering your opponent's life points to zero. Victory by attrition means your opponent ran out of cards, and Exodia win means you drew all five pieces of Exodia, which instantly wins you the duel. As you can see, victory by attrition subtracts 40 rank points, which is a ton. This is why you almost always get the S-Tech rank when you deck your opponent out. Next is how many turns the duel took. Pretty self-explanatory, just count up how many turns the duel took, and add or subtract however many rank points correspond to that number of turns. As you can see, the more turns a duel takes, the more rank points you lose, which pushes you closer to the tech ranks. This is why tech ranks usually take longer than power ranks. Next up are effective attacks. This one requires some explanation. Basically, an effective attack is when you attack and destroy a card and do life point damage at the same time. For example, if you attack a Blue Eyes White Dragon that's in attack mode with a Meteor B Dragon, you'll destroy it and you'll do 500 life point damage. That's an effective attack. Note that this means suiciding your monster does not count as an effective attack since you don't do life point damage. So, for example, if you attack a Meteor B Dragon with your own Meteor B Dragon, both monsters will be destroyed and it will not count as an effective attack. Next are defensive wins. You get a defensive win if the opponent tries to attack one of your monsters that's in defense mode, but they don't destroy it and they take damage in the process. For example, if you play Millennium Shield in defense mode and your opponent tries to attack it with a Dark Magician, your shield will not be destroyed and your opponent will take 500 damage. That is a defensive win. Just like with effective attacks, this means that if the opponent does not take life point damage when they try attacking, it will not count as a defensive win. The next few are pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just going to go through them quickly. First, we have face down plays, which just means playing any card face down. Next, we have initiate fusion, which just means performing a successful fusion. Next is equip magic, which just means successfully using any equipped card. And finally, there's pure magic, which means using any magic card, such as Regeki or Umi. Next is trigger trap, which just means you have to play a trap card and it successfully activates. Note how I mentioned the trap has to actually activate for it to count. Just playing it doesn't count. You have to play it and then have your opponent activate it. For example, playing Widespread Ruin face down does not count as a trap being used just yet, but once your opponent tries attacking you and Widespread Ruin destroys their monster, that's when it counts as a triggered trap. The next variable is cards used. This just means how many cards you drew during the duel. So, for example, if you have 27 cards left, that means you use 13 cards, so you'd get 0 rank points. And finally, the last variable is remaining LP, which is just how many life points you have remaining at the end of the duel. And that's all of them. As you go through the duel, you can keep track of all of these things and figure out how many rank points are being added or subtracted from your starting 50 points, and then you can figure out what rank you'll get. Really quick, I just want to mention how this information was obtained. Believe it or not, all of this information I gave in this video was published in the official Japanese guide for Forbidden Memories. For years, we didn't fully understand how rank worked, and the answer was in the official Japanese guide the entire time. Go figure. That's basically everything. Big thanks to Infamous888 for posting this rank chart on NeoSeeker. I plan on eventually releasing another video that shows off the best methods to get certain ranks, such as A-Tech or B-Pow, so keep an eye out for those soon. I have lots of useful information, including the entire rank points chart, in the description, so be sure to read it. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope y'all learned something. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. So, at the end of every duel in Forbidden Memories, you get a card as a reward. A reward. A reward.
A reward. You get a reward. You get a reward. You get a card. You get a reward.
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier. I remember it so you don't have to.
2
All right. That's the video. I think it looks good, boys. I think we're done here. Pretty much. I gotta write the description and everything. I think that's a good-ass video, y'all. Last thing that I need to do is write up the description, and then just, upload, and we're good to go. Before I do anything else, I just want to save project. Alright, now let's crack open Notepad and write the description really quick. Or no, that's not by Mortis Ghost, I don't think. You not go to somebody's profile on... Oh, here we go. Alright, I think that's the description done. Thumbnail. We will need a thumbnail. I hate thumbnails, because I don't know what I want them to be. Actually, that's all right. I'm good with that. I'm good with that, actually. That gets the point across pretty well, I would say. I'm all right with that. Gets the point across, catches your eye, shows you what you want to know. Fine with that. I'm not a thumbnail artist, so cut me some slack. All right, that is officially everything. The video is officially done, ladies and gentlemen. So I am going to cut the stream so that I can render the video and upload it. And yeah, so keep an eye on your subscription boxes because within the next half hour, the video should be live. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching me make that. That was a lot of fun. Like I said, I know that a lot of you, everyone here has already seen the video, but I would really appreciate it if, you know, 30 minutes from now, or if you're going to bed when you wake up tomorrow, whenever, go to the video, you know, like it, comment on it, stuff like that. It really helps share it. I would really appreciate that. But yeah, the video is all done, so I'm going to go render it and get it everything finished up. So thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. It's 4 a.m. and this is done. So thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. What time is it? It's 4 a.m. right now. So yeah, I stayed up really late working, but hey, we have something to show for it. And I'm really happy about that. So thanks for watching, guys. Remember, keep an eye out for this video. It should be up in the next 30 minutes. All right. All right. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it. Good night and bye-bye.